Greetings. I'm sure we all surf the web. That's probably why you're here. Something made you stop for a listen. I'd like to share a story with you from another video. The speaker is Michael Ramsden, and I am blessed when I hear him speak.
It is amazing to me, in some of the countries I go to, how God reaches out to people. Chairman of our board is an Iranian man, very, very godly. First time I met him, must be 18 years ago, he had a picture on his desk of 35 men. At that point, 18 years ago, half of them had been martyred for their faith in Iran, killed for being Christian pastors. And as I was looking at the photograph, his wife said, "Tell him the story about Elias on the photograph." Elias was driving through northern Iran with his wife, and he pulled into a petrol station to put petrol in the car and buy bottles of water. And as he was about to get out of the car, he saw leaning against the entrance into the little shop a man with a beard, a turban, and a machine gun over his shoulder. And his wife grabbed her husband's arm and pulled him back into the car and said, "You see the guy over there?" He said, "Yeah." He said, "I want you to give him a Bible." And husband, he looked at the gun, he looked at the beard, and he said, "No." And she said, no, honestly, give him a Bible. Put it in her husband's pocket. Her husband went off to go and pay, walked into the shop. The guy with the gun followed him into a shop. A few minutes later, he came out with the bags of water, put them in the back seat of the car. The guy with the gun came out, leaned against the wall, folded his arms, and they drove away. The wife looked at the husband and said, "You didn't give that guy a Bible, did you?" He said, "No, it wasn't the right thing to do." She said, "You should have given him one." He said, "It wasn't the right thing to do." She then bowed her head in the car and prayed out loud, "O Lord, on the day of judgment, may that man's blood be on my husband's head and not mine." He was the one who wouldn't give him a Bible. At this point, the car stopped and they had a friendly conversation that married couples have from time to time. Which ended with the words, "If you want me to die, I will." And then they turned around and they drove back to the station. The guy got out of the car, walked up to this man, gave him a Bible, turned around and started walking back. And then he heard this huge thud behind him. And this guy had collapsed. So he went back and he picked him off the floor. He said, "Are you okay?" And the man said, "I don't live here." He said, "I live 3 days' walk from here. But 3 days ago, I had a dream in which God told me to come and wait in this town until someone gave me the Book of Life. So I'd like to thank you for giving me this book."
The first thought I must share is that time is short. Each time I hear another incredible, credible account of an angel speaking to a Muslim, or a Muslim having a dream or a vision that leads them to the gospel, or the Lord Himself visiting a Muslim in a dream and revealing Himself to them, I think time is short if God is sovereignly speaking directly to Muslims. Truly, God desires that none should perish. 1 Timothy 2:3, "Such prayer for all is good and welcomed before God our Savior, since He wants all people to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth. And He knows all who do not accept the truth will perish." And it brings tears to my eyes just how much God must love Muslims. So let God soften your heart and ask God to honestly place His love in your heart for Muslims. And a second point that has arisen in my awareness is this. Think about the story Mr. Ramsden just told. A Muslim has a dream, and in the dream he is told, "Go to this place, and someone will give you the Book of Life." How many of us would wake up, shake our heads, grimace, and blow it off as a stupid idea? Go 10, 20, 30 miles and wait. Wait until someone comes and gives you the Book of Life. We Western Christians are so sophisticated. We are so afraid someone might mock us or laugh at us. "You did what?" they might say. We might even be so afraid we would not even offer the Bible to the person here in America, let alone an Islamic nation with Sharia, where you may die for sharing your faith. But what did this man do, the one with the beard and the gun? He respected the dream enough to go and to wait. Imagine the thoughts attacking his mind. And yet he stayed and he waited. Is that not a heart hungry to hear the word of life? And God honored his hunger with the book of life. How could you say no? God loves Muslims. Jesus loves Muslims. I believe many Muslims are hungry for the word of life. Be ready to give an answer. They don't need an argument. You have the answer, the truth. Therefore, Jesus said to the 12, "You don't want to go away too, do you?" Simon Peter answered, "Lord, who will we go to? You have the words of eternal life." And later, Acts 5:19, "But an angel of the Lord opened the doors of the jail during the night, brought them out, and said, 'Go and stand in the temple courts and proclaim to the people all the words of this life.'" May the Lord give you a love for Muslims and a hunger to share the word of life. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.